fry them up. Hey everybody, this is Fry. So here is the Green Shadow May-Flourish deck. The reason why we call it that is because of these two cards, Mayflower and Flourish. They both draw tons of cards, and what we were able to do with this deck is make all the rest of the cards very, very cheap and swarmy cards. The curve in this deck is extremely low, meaning the cost of the cards are very low. Most of the cards cost just one or two. There are a couple cards that cost three. There is one Snapdragon and one Espresso Fiesta, which I found is a really great finisher. So you just keep on swarming and playing all these cheap little cards, and you're never going to run out of cards because of all the card draw we have in the deck. We are running four copies of Sweet Potato in this deck. The reason I added those in is because I found that one of the weaknesses of this deck used to be Toxic Waste Imp, and with the Sweet Potatoes you can drag those Toxic Waste Imps out of the water and be able to destroy them with your other minions, and they also provide protection for your minions so they can keep on swarming and keep on hitting face. So I hope you enjoy. This deck was totally unstoppable during our live stream. Here it is. Sort of similar to our zoo that we did before. We are not running any freezing. I tried this deck out with freezing. I tried it with a mix between freezing and peas. It was kind of weird. We're just running peas. That's how this is going. Always get rid of this early on. We have a 1, a 2, and a 3. We're probably not going to use the sweet potato until later. I'm actually going to get rid of the Podfather here. I know that might seem really strange to some of you guys. I actually have two of these cards now, so we'll keep this. Black IP is pretty good against Boogaloo. We'll see what happens here. Alright, and we're going to try to develop these Mayflowers as early as possible. Get all those cards up in here, up in here. What's up, Critteal? What's up, Misty? Happy Thanksgiving to all you guys. Americans and Canadians alike. Canadians, it's not Thanksgiving today, but it's all good. Alright, he'll probably have some kind of lightning bolt in his hand. I wonder if I play the black IP, since it's so likely that he has. He could have evaporate. He has two chances of having it. You know what, if he has a lightning bolt, I would actually rather hit this. One of his two out of four of his powers deal 3 damage, so I'd rather hit this than hit the Mayflower next turn. So it'd actually be good if it comes out of his hand here, and he probably doesn't have it, so he's probably just running either Dancers or Evaporate. So we're doing pretty well. Might see a Dolphin Rider over here. That wouldn't be that great. If we see Dolphin Rider, for example, we'll probably just do what is this? Probably just do the Sweet Potato and a Pea Pod. Double Unlife of the Party. Harsh. Let's see if he has one more little one drop. He has 3 unlives of the party. Okay, we're actually not going to be able to develop Mayflower right now. We're going to play these some combination of these three cards. So let's first tornado, see what we get. Hopefully we get the one in lane 3. That would be great. Perfect. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. We'll go like this. This is fine. So we're going to do Peapod, Torchwood. That's really good. Wow, we were really able to neutralize that. He might come in with a lot more little cards next turn, but that really neutralized the threat. He obviously has one more little Unlife of the Party in his hand. Unlife of the Party Disco would actually be a really good play this coming turn. So, let's see what he has. And we do have Snapdragon, so we're really kind of playing. He had 3 Unlives of the Party in his starting hand, so we're playing a little bit of catch-up here. We do have Snapdragon, which will hopefully be able to get us back into this. We usually use the Snapdragon lane 4 just to protect the water lane, but we'll probably end up using it here. What is he going to do with 3? I don't even know. I wonder if we Snapdragon already. He might play his Dancers, his Dancer power. Yeah, that's probably what's going to happen. Probably will be the Dancers. So this will become a 4. Actually, we have to play Snapdragon here. Yeah, kind of have to. Wait, no, this will become... Wait a second. No, this becomes a 3-4 if he plays the Dancers. What do we even do here? We're going to do the Snapdragon with them, like a Sweet Potato next turn. I think for now we just develop this. That's fine. The Dancers is really not so bad here. He might have a Lightning Bolt in his hand or something like that that he'll use now. But the Dancers turns this to a 3-4, so we'll actually win this matchup. He's just going to have this 1-4-4 on the board we're going to have to deal with, which Snapdragon Sweet Potato will be a good play here. And in the meantime, drawing cards should be fine. No, he didn't have Dancers? Wow. Really confusing. He just played Unlife of the Party that turn, and nothing. What is going on? And that's going to draw us a card. What's in the box? Bouncing Bean. Great card. Wino planned for, there's no room for in this deck. I barely ran one Snapdragon in this deck. The whole point of this deck is you have all your cards cost one or two, and a few cards that cost three, and then just a ton of card draw. It's a zoo deck. You're just swarming them, and drawing cards, swarming them more, drawing cards. This is how we do it. Snapdragon's gonna be really good here. Snapdragon's gonna be amazing here. So it's gonna be Snapdragon. We could, we'll do Snapdragon. And we'll do the sweet potato just to protect it. That's good. We'll see what kind of tricks he has. Obviously not enough brains for chickening. And this is still 5 damage hitting his face. He'll obviously block it this turn. But wow, Snapdragon really got it done. Snapdragon is a 2-for-1. Hopefully he does not get lightning here. I hope he just gets evaporate or something like that. Come on, what's in the box? If he clears the Snapdragon, we are in huge trouble. No, wow. We actually really dodged the bullet. I should have actually factored that into this play there. It was for sure going to block, so I actually did misplay, but we did get fortunate. And there is there's Cobb Cannon. We have Kernel Corn in our hand now. Coming turn 6, this will be incredibly great. So we can bounce something this turn. I have a feeling we're just going to bounce something this turn and just play this guy with the potential. 3 Groshrooms and a Plant Food. I don't think so. We have enough protection. We have 4 copies of Torchwood and 4 copies of Sweet Potato, which are very similar to Plant Food if you think about it, especially the Torchwood. The Groshrooms are kind of good for tempo. I could do that. I think the Groshroom's slightly better, to be honest. So we will bounce this thing off the board. What a great bounce! Bouncing is Valkyrie. The Valkyrie goes back into his hand as an 8-6, and booyah! That's what I'm talking about. This deck is just so great. Look what happened, and if he would have been able to stall for another couple turns, we would have came in with Kernel Corn and just crushed this guy. Oh yes. And here we go. Starting off with a Peapod, Black IP, that's good. Do we keep the card draw in this hand? I don't know if we do. We have so much card draw on this deck, we can actually mulligan this out for something a little better. Got it back. I think we're going to get rid of Sweet Potato. It's not. If it was a Sneaky Hero, then this is way better on turn 3 than the Sweet Potato. So it's going to be turn 1, turn 2, and we will almost for sure have some kind of target on turn 2 to be able to use the... the grocery mounts. That's really good. The trick this next turn is if we see a gravestone in any lane that's not this one, we will front it with the Black IP so the sumo does not take out our 2-2. It's kind of a trick. So that's either a sumo, a squirrel. Could be a sumo. Could be, if it's a sumo, we'd want to keep leave this alone, but it could be a squirrel or a if it's a squirrel or a rat, we'd rather play this. It might be a squirrel. If it's nothing, we want to leave this, but we'll just do this. Black IP is fine. We'll grow the Black IP next turn. And it's just a squirrel, so this will trade. That's really good, and we'll be able to grow the Black IP next turn. If we grow this Black IP at 4 or 5, he's not going to be able to deal with it in turn 5 and use a Locust Storm on it. So this is an extremely good play here, going with the Groshroom. We are going to be opening up some packs today, too. That's really exciting. Thank you guys for donating the last little bit of money for the pack. So that'll be happening at 2 o'clock. We will be opening up 70 packs today. Guys, stay tuned for that. 70 packs. There's an extra sale that when you buy 50, instead of getting extra 10, you get an extra 20. So this is really good. We're playing the Groshroom on the right here, so this 4 attack hits first. He had nothing on turn 3. He was probably just playing. You know what he's playing on Weed Spraying. So this plays so well around Weed Spray, the Groshroom, instead of spraying a Weed Spray on a 2-1. We have to try to keep in mind that he has Weed Spray in his hand. We are going to, I think the Flaming Pea is good. We might freeze this as well. This is kind of like a major problem for him. This actually wins this matchup next turn, so maybe we shouldn't. We're actually going to develop 2-2, so this one's fine. And we're just going to keep rushing the board. Here we go. We have so many ways of dealing with this later by freezing it or sweet potatoing it. So, I mean, look what we're doing to him. He's going to be down to, what is he going to be down to? 5 health now. Hopefully he won't block. No, he probably will now. Ah, he blocked in 3. That's so cheap. He's down to 8. Which is fine. At least that will be probably his last block for this game. There's Espresso Fiesta if we ever need it. We're definitely going to draw cards this turn. We could freeze this, sweet potato, etc. I think we're actually going to sweet potato this out of here. So we're really one off of lethal. Sweet potato here and dragging this coach over. Actually, the 7 damage. Welcome to the stream, my news follower, Dino Slayer. So let's look for an answer. We'll do this. We actually can freeze something just to kind of draw another answer here. Grow shroom, not enough. We're going to go with just the sweet potato here. Doing a little extra damage this turn will be fine. Do we freeze something? Not really sure. Do we freeze just to draw another card? Do we freeze to draw a card? We can freeze this coach, and then this will live next turn. We kind of actually want one of our minions to die, so no, we're not going to freeze. Actually, the sooner one of our minions die, the better, because we have a Groshroom in our hand, so... Alright, oh, smash power, nice play, but this other black IP will actually go to a 3-4, so it will be able to trade with this. We'll probably end up freezing this coach next turn. He's down to 5, and we're just waiting for turn 8. Once turn 8 hits, we are for sure going to win with this kind of board. Expresso Fiesta is going to finish this guy off. So it looks like freeze Groshroom looks pretty good. Too bad we can't, growing this would be nice. Don't know where that's going to be. That's probably going to be a sumo. It's almost for sure a sumo. I think we leave the arm wrestler alone for now. Alright, so let's freeze this one. This is kind of our most powerful guy on the board. Let's see what we get. Mayflower would obviously be really good here. Give this man a Mayflower. I think I'm going to go with... We could Groshroom. We could Groshroom just to make this a thing and actually kill this coach here. Otherwise, we can grow this one. We're going to use a Groshroom. We're going to be able to take this out with just the Peapod. The question is, do we want to take out the Sumo, or do we want to take out this coach? This will be a trade, and we want more of our more lanes open for next turn, so this will be just a trade. The Sweet Potato will go somewhere. No one really cares where it goes, but this will actually... All right, he's going to be able to move the Sweet Potato wherever he wants, but any lane that this goes to is fine. Any lane will actually create a favorable matchup for us. He stuck it behind there. That's okay. But again, this lane being protected, we're going to have a peep. We'll just be able to... this will be a 4-4. Doesn't really matter. We're just stalling for turn 8. Once turn 8 comes, we're going to have two strong minions on the board here. We'll be able to do a couple more. Ooh, flag. Nice play. Wait for a big card to freeze. Wow, this is actually a 4-3 now. This is a trade. We're still in very good shape. This will actually be a 4-1, so I was able to make this coach survive, which is okay. We can just peapod it down or whatever. It's turn 7, one turn more to Expresso Fiesta. That's what I'm talking about. There's that. We can turn this into a freeze factory. This is probably just another sumo. Probably just another sumo. In which case, I believe, well, he's going to want to move the... what do we do here, actually? I think we go like this. I'll put this here. I'll put this here, actually. Here? Do we develop Peapod? Not quite sure. Expresso Fiesta is gonna be good here. I'll probably just end up moving the Torchwood into this lane. He's gonna move the sweet potato somewhere, the Torchwood somewhere. I might stick the Torchwood behind something. He wants to take out this black IP. Not a bad play, actually. This black IP is gonna be the one that's gonna be able to Expresso Fiesta this next turn. He has only 5 health, so we're in pretty good shape if he doesn't have one more little thing to play. He frenzied that, so this just becomes better. So the Expresso Fiesta actually just became better here. This actually won't do a bonus attack because of the freeze, so Expresso Fiesta should win here. No reason why not. Even if he fronts us with something, we just need one shot from this black IP. So, 25 Celsius here, it's about 5, or it's 10 maybe. Wow, kind of jealous. That's fine, Yeti. Chicken buffs everything up. And Expresso Fiesta time! Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Here we go! Yes, that's guaranteed lethal! Go with the finish! Boom! That's what I'm talking about. you just didn't get the impression that he was in that game at all. We have 19 health at the end of that game. Do you guys see what we're doing? We're just clogging every lane. It's so great. Ah, this is how you zoo deck.
That is how it's done. 31, cool. It's like the middle of summer for you guys. Here it's winter. Other hemisphere. Podfather's theoretically good. Let's see what we get out of this. 1, 2. 3. Should we try the Podfather this time? Okay, we're going to try it. We're going to try Podfather on 3. Hopefully it works out. We're definitely going to play this Peapod in the middle lane, just so it's able to be protected by our superpower. You kind of always want to make your turn 1 play in the middle lane in this. Cool. Podfather Peanut? Peanut, no. Alright, summer's coming, yeah. A lampshade? Did one of them have a lampshade on their head? I didn't realize that. What is this? Try hard deck? What is this? Wow, the one turn kill. That's what I'm talking about. So protecting this Peapod is actually our top priority right now, so we're going to do this. This will be a 3-3 next turn, so in terms of our tempo, it's going to be amazing. The other great thing is he's going to have to deal with this growing 3-3 next turn, so we're going to be able to come in with a Podfather and then on turn 4 play 2 Ps. That'll be amazing. Oh, 35 Fahrenheit. They're talking Celsius, Misty. Here it's probably right. It's also, it's... Celsius, 35, you know, 30 Celsius is obviously really a lot. This is not going to be able to take out the Podfather, whatever it is. I don't think he has any options. It could be a red or something like that, but we're going to be in really good shape. I think we do this in 2 or in 4. We want potentially be able to be protected by a 1, 2, 3. Here, just in terms of the block meter, on average, this will hit next turn. So, that's a trash. That's fine. So this will actually end up trading with this thing. We're going to be able to play the 2 Flaming Peas next turn. They're going to have 2 5-4s on the board on turn 4. This is going to be amazing. Watch this, guys. This is insanity. Utter insanity. He's going to put something in front of the Podfather, but just look what happens. Hopefully he just plays a Sumo and we're able to front the Sumo with these two things. But just the 2 5-4s here, he's never going to be able to come back from this. Come on, man. This is a zoo deck. It is zoo deck. You're trying to swarm and swarm and swarm, running just the 2 Podfather, not really a Podfather deck, and you draw so many cards. The thing that enabled us to make this deck is the Mayflower. What? He did nothing? What are you doing, man? He skipped turn 4? Oh, I feel so bad for this guy. Look at this board. We are going to do 10 damage this turn. If he's not able to deal with the Podfather here, we're just going to play another P next turn and draw some cards. What is happening? Oh my. What is he? He's never going to... He's just frenzying. Nobody cares. We're just going to be able to play another 4-4 here next turn. Against a 2... It'll be against a 2-1 with Frenzy. Great. He's not dealing with the Podfather. Huge mistake. Huge mistake. That was his... Okay, he weed sprayed just the Podfather. Good for him. He was planning on Weed Spraying this turn. That's really why he passed that turn, but did not work out for him at all. He really blocked the 3, kind of annoying. Whoa, that's becoming 2-2. That's pretty annoying. Well, that's actually a huge threat right now. It's a 4-3. It's not terrible. We do have the 2 huge minions on the board, and he's down to 10 health. So, we're probably going to draw cards and play 2-drop here. It won't get the bonus attack if we freeze it, so maybe freezing and playing Black IP here is really the play. Probably is. Really? Is this a Sumo? What is he planning on doing here? Okay, let's just do this play. Just want to clog every lanes in case that's a Sumo, so he won't be able to drag anything. And no! We have Lethal on the board! He can't deal with these with 3. What would he have? He would need a Nibble to survive. That is the only card that can save him right now, I think. Nibble for the save. We are going to win here on turn 5 with this deck. Podfather with Flaming Peas. Come on, we didn't even need card draw. We have in our hand just in case he would be able to survive here. But Nibble's the only card that can save this dude. Come on, man. Vitamin C? What a bad play. That's what I'm talking about. This should, unless he rolls double threes, which Murphy's Law says he will. No, that's guaranteed lethal on turn five. This will get frozen. It'll just miss its bonus attack, the frenzy attack, but that's the game. Oh, that was awesome. That was so insane. That was crazy. what's up, Tamir? Yeah, 50 bucks is about 200 shekels. Exactly. It's about 4 to 1 now. where's Papa Fry? Okay, so this is good on turn 1, turn 2. In case he has Toxic Waste, we're going to keep these. So we're just going to keep this hand. This is good. And the Black IP are just amazing against Super Brain, so definitely want to keep as many copies of Black IP in the deck. He runs usually a lot of tricks, so this will be great. We're going to Torchwood on 1. I wonder if for tempo we... Ooh, that's kind of harsh. We might have to leave this on the board until turn 3. I wonder if we just get this out of here right now. That is kind of harsh, this 3-2. What are we get? We don't really have a good way of dealing with that. I wonder if we gust it out. Other plays just Torchwood, but Torchwood in 3. And then we can stick this behind it next turn. Do we play a foot race with this guy? Where he's going to get a little bit ahead. He could rocket this on... Well, turn 3 we could do these two. It's kind of risky, but we're going to take 3 damage to the face here. What is... Nobody plays Pokemon Go. Go away. I'm joking. There's... Wow. Alright, so we definitely have to get rid of this Toxic Waste Imp. That's a good play. We'll be able to do the, it's really good he's spending a Toxic Waste. Toxic Waste Imp is actually one of the things that can really ruin the deck that we're playing right now. So, that's where we're running the Sweet Potatoes, be able to drag the Toxic Waste, inbound. Wow. So, we can actually, get ahead this turn. We can actually gust something and then play these two. We're probably gonna try that. Let's see what we gust. Does he have another little imp? Okay, so we're going to save the sweet potato to take this thing out. We could do the sweet potato play and just do as a black... Oh, wait, we can. Oh, we can do all that. Oh, we're just going to do this. Yeah, this is fine. Put a Torchwood here. And put a sweet potato here. We'll gust something in a bit. Definitely want to kill the Toxic Waste Imp as soon as possible. So that's why we are running sweet potatoes in this deck. To be able to trade with Toxic Waste Imp. And essentially, in terms of tempo, we're trading a 1-drop for his 2-drop, so if he doesn't have another play here, we're in really good shape. Hopefully he doesn't have a Smoke Bomb to bring this back. That would be really sad. Only trick he can have for 1 is Smoke Bomb. Or Teleport, but Teleport obviously doesn't do anything here. Or Telepathy. Yeah, I guess that works too. That's right. Alright, and this, our Black IP just became a 3-4 because of that, so we're just going to develop another Black IP and another Flaming P. We really need Mayflower. This is the time in the game that we really need it. If he plays a huge 4-drop, like a Height Climber or something like that, we'll definitely blow it away and do another Black IP. If not, we'll just play these two. If he plays something at cost 4, though, this is going to be a really good Gust target. See what he does. Usually just a Gravestone of the sorts. Like an electrician in lane 3. Looks pretty legit. Why no squat? There's no squashes in this deck, obviously. I wonder if blowing this away is good. We could blow it away or we could do the Black IP. Black IP here. This'll get us more on the boom. Card advantage, we're really low on cards right now, so we kind of want to utilize every card as much as we can. Killing this as soon as possible is probably actually the best play, so we'll do this. These Black IPs are really strong. We can maybe blow this away next turn. I don't know. We could have blown it away and done just the Black IP. I wonder if that's better. Just because he's going to need tricks to catch up here. He's Super Brains. And he's not in not in good shape at all here. We're going to have 7 damage on face this turn. I'll be down to 11, just like that. No, he blocked in 3. These guys get so lucky. Oh, he blocked in 3 shots. Give this guy a normal block meter. Mayflower is the perfect, perfect card. We are going to start drawing now. Every single turn drawing 2 cards. It's going to be very... He already used a Toxic Waste. It's going to be very hard for him to deal with this Mayflower. So, we'll do this. I think we actually blow this away just to keep the tempo on the board. And what's in the box? It's just a pirate. He's planning on using a bonus attack this turn. He's going to bonus attack. I don't know what this guy was going to do, actually. The pirate's useless. Give this guy Space Cadet, just buffs these two. It does nothing here. At least take out the flaming pea shooter with the Space Cadet. A series of terrible plays by Undeadly. Ah, okay. Fine. That made it good. This still becomes a 4-3. These two will be cleared. We're going to have 3 minions on the board, so including the extra card, we're going to have just a 1 card advantage off, but, you know, especially with a black IP on the board, we're definitely way ahead in this game, and this will draw a card. Luckily, it didn't block there again in 3. Great Zucchini! Oh, we can't play this for another few turns. It actually would have been better to get something smaller here. This will come in handy eventually. He's down to 6, so just Great Zucchini in the water lane will win eventually. We're at 14 health. We're doing really well. Okay. This is not really a threat here at all. I think we're actually going to try to preserve this one. This might just be another swashbuckler or something like that. And it's just... okay, that's fine. So that's a great trade for us. If he plays any tricks, also, this just grows, so he's not going to be able to take care of this black IP. This black IP is insane. He is having a real hard time, and we're going to draw another card. There's a bonus attack. Does that kill this? Oh, it does. Oh, wow, good job. So he did take out the black IP there. We need a good card here. A laser beam or something would be amazing from this Mayflower. What is in the box? There you go. Come on, laser beam. Oh, we have Cornucopia. We're just stalling for time here. Ah! Okay, Groshroom. Really smaller cards would be so much better. I don't know what this is going to be, but we have to just... We're just stalling. Just stalling. So we're going to buff up this one. We actually don't want something... We don't want this dying to rocket this turn, so we're actually going to buff up the... we're actually going to buff up the Torchwood. Kind of weird. Anti-hero. Oh, we nailed that. Give this guy a smoke bomb. Yeah, he has smoke bomb. Oh, nice. That's 7 damage to face. That's actually half of our health pool, but we have lethal this turn if he doesn't not able to deal with the 5 damage here. Otherwise, even if he has a rocket, we're still going to be doing 4 damage this turn. Unless he has bounce, yeah. And this should be lethal here. He could get carried away and save himself by carried away here, but that's the only thing that could save him at this point. So he's going to carried away over to the Torchwood. He will be down to 2. We will have another card on the board. And a bonus attack. Oh no, we're going to block his next shot. Yeah, he has no chance of winning this. Bounce. Bounce looks good. Bounce is actually a great pickup here. It's actually an amazing pickup here. So we'll definitely be bouncing something. We also are about to block, so we should have this. The 26 Valtry, cool. This Mayflower. We're really not going to get any value from the card draw of this Mayflower, by the way. It'll just come in handy, but we're going to win this turn no matter what. I don't think he's going to have any outs. It would be so... We're going to be able to bounce. It's pretty rough for him on this board right now. Great Zucchini for sure, and Cornucopia, but... This was really not great. It would have been so much better to get Black IPs or Laser Beans or, I don't know, even, you know, Bean Counter would have been amazing. Welcome to the stream, our newest follower, 18s. Welcome to the stream, and we got this one. We got this one. We are 4 games in a row now with this deck. Mayflower. Mayflower is the key. You cannot run a deck like this without tons of card draw, and this is how you do it. It happens to be that right now in the game, besides for some of the brainy heroes, the most card draw in the game is Green Shadow. But this is how it goes. Ramp Rose with Mayflower? I'll tell you why Ramp Rose with Mayflower I don't think is a good idea. Ramp Rose anyway is so late game. There's not enough... The time you need card draw is when all your cards are early, and Rose has very poor early game, besides for the freezing, of course. We could try a freeze rose, but I don't know what's the point. Green shadow just seems better in all ways. All right, here we go. We have a 2. We have a 3. Don't need the sweet potato in this matchup. This could be 2, 3, 4. Let's keep this. This did work out for us once, so let's see if we can get some Podfather value. And we got a little freeze. Little freeze. I am not sweating. Do I look like I'm sweating? I'm actually pretty cool right now. Rip sweet potatoes, right? What is this? This guy's playing as like the loser guy. What is he doing? What is this guy doing? We don't want to get weed sprayed next turn. That's the only thing that could really get us. So we're actually going to play this one instead of Black IP. I know this seems like a really weird play. We're going to play this one instead. We're trying to develop Podfather next turn and not get weed sprayed. Meaning he's not going to want to weed spray next turn now that we just have a 3-2 on the board. So it'll make it more likely for the Podfather to be able to survive. And then if we can come in with these two P's the turn after that, it's going to be amazing. What is with all these little guys? What is going on here? We maybe should still play around. I'm thinking of still playing around Rolling Stone. So this is actually immune to Rolling Stone, this one. So we're going to go with the Muscle Sprout. I'm just going to leave all this garbage dry. What is he doing? Is this a king deck? Maybe this is a king deck and he's bluffing by playing all these random little creatures. We actually might see a king next turn. If we do, though, we have a perfect answer. We have the Black IP and the, we actually have the perfect answer to kings right now. We're going to keep that. Rank 99 with 19 stars? What? Oh, is this guy really rank 7? Oh, poor him. We do have Mayflower. We'll probably end up doing the Podfather play on turn 5. I don't know what this guy's doing. Give us a break. Playing two creatures would be really nice here. But we actually can't play two. The only two we can play are these, but we're going to want to do that with the Podfather in a bit. I think we just Mayflower. Just Mayflower is good. And we'll do a Podfather play of the sorts next turn. Let's see here. If this is a sumo, is there anything we would like to freeze here? This one. Maybe we freeze this one, so at least this trades. Something's going to get traded here. So at least it trades with the 2-1. Freeze this one. Is this a weird... No, we'll save. Let's save the cards in our hands. The freeze will be fine. I'll draw us a card a little bit later. He'll destroy our Flaming P, probably. He might go after the... He went after this one. Okay. That's fine. I'm happy I didn't freeze anything now. Does he have a Rolling Stone? Rolling Stone would take this out. In which case, he definitely should have moved the P here. No, he's just healing himself. Okay. We definitely have... Yeah, it was probably going to block the Mayflower there anyway, right? Oh, he got a... Wow, he has a Rolling Stones? Why did he not move the Flaming P over to this lane? This guy's not making such good plays here. We're going to develop the Podfather. It's going to be Podfather, Black IP, something like that. It's good that the Rolling Stone is out of his hand there. Podfather's going to be amazing. And we have a Torchwood next turn to protect the Podfather. So it's going to be Podfather, Black IP. That's going to be a good play. He might just stall past this turn for a Locust Swarm on the Muscle Sprout, but that's also alright because we're going to have a lot of really strong minions on the board right now. He might be able to clear this out. We actually would like the Muscle Sprout to hit face, so we're going to do it like this. Can he? He could buff up this creature, and we really would like the... he could Vitamin Z this turn. We really would like the Podfather to survive one more turn and get a little more value out of it. So let's go like this. The difference between 3 damage makes this play actually better. What's up, Dino? What's up, Cade? No Mayflower, I know. Sorry, guys. Bye-bye, Mayflower. Guys, get Mayflower, though. It is so worth it. It's not that expensive, too. Monster Mash! Alright. So, this becomes a 4-3 on the board. This gets buffed up. That was a really sad Monster Mash. Maybe this will proc a block. No. He'll block the Muscle Sprout. That's fine. He destroyed with the Superpower. But again, that coming out on a 2-2 on just the pot. We got enough value from the Podfather already. That buffs this again. We are so far ahead on this board right now. It's pretty insane. There is Peapod. So we can just Peapod, Torchwood, Snow, freeze. Oh, now we're only gonna have four. Oh, what are we gonna do? We're gonna go for lethal. We actually have lethal this turn. Yep. This is how we do it. So it's gonna be these two and a freeze. Like this. Nobody cares. That's lethal. That's actually guaranteed lethal. Die! We will freeze you for BM! Can we freeze his face? That would be nice. I wish you could just freeze their face just to BM. But that is 14 damage on board and one man wrecking crew. That is what this deck is. Not the one man. This is like the 100 man wrecking crew. That would actually be a good name for this deck. It's so swarmy, and that's the game, folks. 5-0. Bring it on. I don't think the event cards are going to be craftable, guys. I really don't think it will be. I think they're going to come around once a year. You might be able to wait till next Thanksgiving, next year, in order to get it, but I have a feeling these event cards are going to be exclusive. They say they're exclusive. I really don't think these are going to be craftable eventually, but maybe they will be. Oh, it's multi-pack time! Let's do it! It's time for pets, 2 o'clock, we have 60 viewers, let's go! We're gonna open up 70 packs! Are you guys ready? Look at this beautiful number, I love this! It says 5,000 and you guys can't see, it's a little cut off on the top of the screen. But, oh yes, are you guys ready? Oh, 50 plus 20, there's actually a sale right now, which is why we're kind of rushing to open up the packs. I actually bought a couple of gems yesterday. Just to get kind of bump us up. Here we go. Are you ready? Are you ready for this? 70. Watch this huge stack. I'm taking a screenshot of the stack here. I don't know. Is the game going to have an error when it has to stack up 70 packs? 68, 69, 70. Screenshot. Are you guys ready? Are you guys ready? Here we go. Should we get some pack music on? Let's get some pack music on. I'm gonna get let's use the fry 'em up theme music here. Here we go. Are you guys ready? It's called pack music. Bring it on. And here we go. 70 packs. Here comes all the uncommons. Oh yeah, that's right, 70 packs, pump it up. Yeah, fourth trickster would be nice. Any legendaries, as many legendaries as possible. So we're getting tons of copies of like every uncommon in the game here. Obviously don't need them, they will be uncraftable, so we'll just get some extra sparks from these, and here we go. no code giveaways for now, we'll probably do that eventually. Alright, pack music. I have a feeling I'm going to make this the theme music of the channel. I'm going to make a little intro video. It'll be cool. Alright, here's the rares. Getting one copy of all rares so far. There's two. A couple cherub bombs. Got the poison oak, black eyed peas. I have four copies of all these already. Plant food. Good card. All good cards. Except for magic beans. It's a terrible card. But here we go, get some tacos, get some lawnmowers. We have four copies of all these. We have, except for like Wrath, I think that's the only one we don't have four copies of. So we got like three more copies of Wrath, that would be cool. Just complete the collection, even though I have no idea what deck I would use it in. That's right. Here we go. Legendary drop rate, I think, is actually better when you're buying 50 packs at a time, so. We're having some predictions for two cornucopias. We got some jesters. Looks like we did not get any wraths, though. That's okay. Only thing in the rare we're really looking for. Good cards. Got six monster mashes. Holy cow. Four rodeos. Four. We got four toxic waste imps. Rares are fine. They're uncraftable. You can craft other things with them. Alright, here comes the super rare. This is what we're looking for. Another Myrnaut. That's Myrnaut number 5. Pineclone! Yes! We got Pineclone number 1. That is the main super rare. We got another cap. Wow, another strong berry. Okay, we already have a lot of bean counters. Got two of those. Another Brainanas. Awesome. Yes! Here's Chomper. That's Chomper's number like 5 and 6. Yeti, already have like 8 copies of that. Got two of those. Maniacal Laugh. Awesome. Awesome. Mad Chemist, don't need any more of those. Another second Portal Technician, awesome. Here's Valkyrie, number like 8. Discotron, I think we have 4 of those already. A fourth King, yes! Line Dancer, 2 Line Dancers! We got the Line Dancer's the main card. Oh, I'm bringing Face Infinity back. Here comes the Legendaries, really excited here. Yes! Soul Patch number 2, here we go. Dandelion King number 2, which is probably how many you want in the deck, is 2. Doppelgvint! Doppelgvint favorite, yes! Oh, Wintermelon. Don't have any of those yet. Great Zucchini number 3 we have. Sorry, I'm yelling to the mic. Three-headed Chopper! Oh, it's so good! Here comes the Viking. Two Vikings! We just got two. Everyone dance. Here we go. King deck. We actually, yeah, we kind of need a fourth one. Did not get any Tricksters. We got a Doubling Mint, though. I'm going to experiment with this in tempo Grass Knuckles. I don't even know if I would put four of these in the deck. I'd probably just put one or two. We do have the Melon. I don't know how to... This is going to open up the whole freezing thing. You know, just to have a huge freezing card. This could be really useful in Ramp Rose. I'm going to stick this into all the Freeze Rose decks are going to have a copy of this in it. Let's see what else we have here. Let's pump up the music again just while we're analyzing the cards that we got. Three-Headed Chomper is going to go in every Solar deck. I cannot imagine a deck that this will not go into. This is so key. The fact that this is a plant, too. You play this after the fact. You can take out Gargantuar's with this thing, whatever you want. Craft a Trickster. Well, I'm going to let, again, in terms of crafting right now, I'm going to let the people who donate to the channel decide. So people who donate, I mean, for no reason, if it's four packs for buying things, obviously it doesn't count. But people who are just normal channel donators, so you can see the terms below. Anyone who donates $15 can design a super rare, which Pineclone would probably be the main one that we need right now, and 50 on a legendary. So I'm going to let the channel donators decide on that. So we have another, I don't think we're ever going to run three Great Zucchinis in a deck. Welcome to the stream, news follower, stay sick. The cards I'm really excited about, we have one Pineclone. Which finally we have a Pineclone. Could really use about two more in order to make decks out of this. I'm really excited about this card. I know this card seems kind of meh to you guys, Land Dancing Zombie, but this exactly two of these is the super rares that I wanted. We are going to start making some face decks, and this is really a key card in a face deck because it's a really solid turn 3 play, which is really what the face decks were missing. Really, on turn 4 you have like Stealthy Imp Smoke Bomb and stuff like that, or Chickening. So this is going to really, I'm going to bring back Face Infinity. This is going to be so good with these extra Line Dancing Zombies. I'm going to craft, again, when people who donate to the channel put in their request, that is when I will disenchant and craft things. Third Brain Nano's good, I think we're going to use that. We have, this is our, I think our fourth Grapes of Wrath, which is going to be useful in a lot of decks. Second Maniacal also, we only had one until now, so that's really good. Fourth King, I think there's going to be some decks, we're going to maybe bring back the King decks with four Kings. It really makes a difference in having three and four. Sergeant Strongberry, we already have four of these. Already have so many. I'm Bean Counter has been my. We got two in this one also. Bean Counter, I have gotten so far total in this game probably about 12 Bean Counters, including these ones. Chompers, we already have. Discotron, really all these cards we already have four copies of. Second Soul Patch is really exciting though, because that, in terms of like, especially ramp decks like the Walnut ramp deck, that's something that's really going to be useful in terms of ramping up, protecting you. The second Dandelion King also, I can actually make, now that I have two Dandelion Kings, I can actually make a deck around it. Doubling Mint is like the cheapest, most versatile legendary. I'm really, really excited about this card. Wintermelon's going to be hard to fit into a deck, we're going to find it. The two Vikings are probably going to go in finishers in our teleport deck, so, alright. Great haul. Great haul. Friendly Versus will be at 2:45 p.m. Eastern Time. Do I have a name for all my decks? Yeah, most of my decks I'll name them somehow. So, usually I'll name them something. Sometimes more creative, sometimes it's more bland. Alright, great haul. So we're going to continue with our Green Shadow deck. There's really nothing here we're actually going to add into the Green Shadow deck. There is Doubling Mint. Do you know what? I'm going to stick a Doubling Mint somewhere into that deck and we're going to see how that does. I think it's going to be the Snowpea. That's probably the worst card in this deck right now. And we are going to stick the Doubling Mint in. Welcome to the stream, my newest follower, Polar Paladin. Welcome to the stream. So, Doubling Mint is going right up in here. But, yes, live in Canada. What's up? And welcome to the stream, my newest follower, Piokibo. Welcome to the stream. Alright, we have a good one, a good two, possibly a good three. We're going to get rid of the card draw for now. We'll get some back later. And that's a pretty good hand. What? I only use free songs though, so there are free, you know, copyright free YouTube like libraries and stuff that you get your music from. So I don't want to get it. I am running a channel here, so I can't get into any copyright infringement stuff. We're gonna put this in the middle lane, so it'll be protectable. We'll see if he has a plumber. He might have it, or a superpower. When Infinity plays a superpower on turn one, is kind of hard to stop. There's plumber number one. At least it won't take out the flaming next turn. There's Mayflower. That's good. Probably do that next turn. There's that. We're not gonna front that. This is better. We'll find a 2-3 or something later to be able to deal with this. We actually might see the Imp Commander next turn. I wonder if we should have traded here. I wonder if we'll see Imp Commander. If we see Imp Commander, we're gonna develop the Peapod. What is this? Okay, so let's see what he could have here. It could be Bomb, it could be it's probably Smelly Zombie. That's the most likely case. Problem is, if we put a Torchwood, we're just kind of lost that turn. Do we go with just the Mayflower then? We could Podfather and then Podfather Torchwood next turn. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Let's go with this. This one's going to hit and hit, so we're going to actually want to put this on Heights, so this will be the Torchwood one next turn. This will probably be a Smelly Zombie. There you go. That's fine. Which team? I think they're pretty balanced. There's great decks for both plants and for zombies. I can't say that I do better necessarily with one than the other. Alright, here comes Smelly Zombie. Wow, so that's really good. We're going to be able to Podfather and Torchwood this turn. Why is he doing this? He must have Deadly in his hand. Yeah, it must be what's happening. So we're going to do this play. We're going to play the Podfather. And we're going to play a Torchwood over here, just so this does not die to the Deadly. He's definitely packing a Deadly in his hand. Come on. Oh no, he might be packing a Plumber. Plumber also, this is a good play just to prevent the damage. Yeah, he's packing a Plumber. That's alright. This was turn 4, so we're going to be able to put a P over here and Deadly. He has both? What just happened? No, that really messes us up, actually. We're probably going to actually use our superpower on this now. Anything else we can get rid of here will be fine. Yeah, so let's definitely use the Tornado. Any of these. We just need a clear lane for next turn. That's fine. That's actually probably the best one that we could have cleared out. Having a Deadly Ninja is kind of harsh. Wow, we can play two of these and use our superpower. Yeah, we're going to double up on the P. We'll do the Mayflower on turn 6. That looks pretty good. What is up? What does Mayflower do? Mayflower draws lots of cards for you every time it hits face. That's what it does. Pharaoh Zombie? Podfather 3-peater? Yeah, it works. I'm not running any 3-peaters in this deck, though. What's up, Night Owl? What's up, Gil? What's up, everybody? Yeah. What is he doing here? So we're going to be able to play all three of these, clear out the Smelly Zombie here. Give us a break. Is he quitting already? Did we just win just like that? I mean, we were going to take over the board so easily here. Give this guy some skills. He didn't like it. He has nothing. That's weird. Okay, definitely using the superpower. The one we want to be protected. Let's see here. What would we rather be protected? A 3-3 that grows or a 4-4? Actually, no, wait. Protected? No, there's no difference in terms of protection. So we want this one to hit face first, so we'll be able to put 8 damage on his face this turn. And it's really good. Get some double value here. Oh, yes. Just the 3 damage, it'll probably block his first shot, too. I have 3 chances of blocking the first shot, so this way we'll have 8 damage on face. He might have chickening here or something, but chickening obviously doesn't help him at all. I mean, it'll put a little damage onto my minions. He totally passed turn 5. Give us a break. Give this guy a superpower or something. Him getting brute strength on this would actually be quite powerful. We're actually probably going to have to put a minion on this next turn. That is going to be 5 damage. We're on a 3-turn clock with that right now. That's kind of harsh, actually. That is very harsh, but he's down to 3 just like that. There's Snapdragon. It's going to be Snapdragon instead of the Mayflower. Yep. We'll save the Mayflower. Snapdragon will help clear these lanes up too, so hopefully this 4 will be able to hit. He's going to have to block all 3 of these lanes in order to survive here. There's Flamengo. That does 2 damage to face. Does he have a Plumber in his hand? No, he can't have a Plumber. So this is fine. This is lethal. This is gonna, well, if this will clear out the ninja, so if he blocks and get his superpower, then I guess he could survive, but he's probably not gonna block here. We're gonna be down to 2. Kinda harsh. We're actually within range of, no, he blocked! And that's the game. Okay. In fact, if he got his superpower and landed in 4 and 5, he actually would have won that game. But, alright. That was a battle of two people trying to rush each other down, and in terms of foot races, we're usually pretty good in this deck. We are 6-0 now.